Welcome to Real George's Backroom. Tonight, we have a great show lined up for you. Recently, Gene went to the Palace Theater to speak with George Thorogood for the Backroom.
Welcome to the Back Room. This is Gene, and we're here at the Palace Theater in Albany with George Thorogood of George Thorogood and the Destroyers. George, you've been on tour a long time, and here you're back in Albany. You've been in the area before. How do you like this area?
Coming upstate New York, it's always a pleasure for myself and the Destroyers, Gene, especially Albany, Syracuse, the Rochester, Buffalo area. I've always looked forward to it, and sorry it took us 2 years to get back, but...
Has it been 2 years?
Mm-hmm. We were at J.B. Scott's, was it?
Ah.
There's such a place?
Oh, yeah.
Am I saying that right?
Yes, you're saying it right.
Or is it T.B. Scott's?
No, J.B. Scott's.
J.B. Scott's.
Mr. Thorogood, we'll give you some time to get it right. Tonight, we also have the band Interstate, a band full of talent and fun. Woohoo! Their live sets now include almost 50% original material, including Bob Sullivan's tune, White Line. Also, Bruce Hallenbeck of Metroland Magazine and QBK AM Radio begins his series of movie reviews for the Backroom. This may seem like a full half hour of entertainment to you, but there's more on the Backroom. An interview with Skyway's Doug Dickens and Jim Whiten premieres his new videotape, The Best Part. You might remember Jim from The Existentials. Well, here he is now with his brand new recording.
welcome to the back room. This is Gene, and we're here at the Skyway Bowl with Doug Dickens, the fellow who books the bands here at the Skyway. Hi, Doug.
How you doing, Gene?
We have 805 here tonight. We were talking about the different kinds of bands that you're bringing in. You bring in a real variety.
We try to get the largest variety that we can. We want to make sure that the room is available to just about every conceivable type of music at this point, and as well as every conceivable type of crowd, because the place is a real nice place. We like to show it off. We like people to come in and have a good time. That's the main thing.
Yeah, it can fit quite a few people, and it's really the biggest club in this Scotia Schenectady area. It's really accessible to a lot of people. Now, we have a rock band here tonight. You were saying you're going to be bringing in some jazz acts and things like this?
Planning on doing some jazz. On Sunday afternoons, we have polka. Okay, we have Polish bands in here. We're planning in January, starting January 9th, we're going to have big band, 13-piece big band, doing Glenn Miller and Tommy Dorsey and the whole stick for dancing, you know, and just listening pleasure too, you know, and it's variety.
A real variety, yeah, and I guess I do see the name all the time in the publication, so it's a matter of just keeping your eyes out and seeing what's here at the Skyway. And I know you recently had a barbecue. I was here for that, the chicken barbecue. That went off well.
Yeah, it went off very well. We got another one planned for next weekend.
For next weekend? I thought it was annual. It's like 12 of them annual.
You know, when you got chicken to eat, you eat chicken, you know?
Had some leftover, huh? Now, we were talking about the video screen you have over there in the corner, and you were saying you're going to be having some upcoming video showcases, more or less.
Right. I've been talking to some people down in the southern tier of the state who do film shows, okay? They've got different shows, like The Doors, they got The Beatles. The first one I want to try is The Beatles. We had Apple in here recently. They used to play J.B. Scott's. And they did very, very well. People really respond to the Beatles. And in fact, I think the Beatles are more popular now than they were when they first came out. It's just amazing, you know. And I think a Beatles show in here, a film show, would be really good.
So Apple is like a Beatles clone band?
Essentially, yeah. It's a type of band that they do three separate shows, three separate changes of clothes. They use all the same equipment that the Beatles originally used, and it's a really, really class act, you know. We've got them coming back in January, too.
It's probably as good or better than Beatlemania, probably in a lot of ways.
In a lot of ways, I think it probably is. People seem to respond to it.
Okay, now, Doug, you've worked in a lot of bars, and you've been here for a while. Do you have any words of advice or maybe ways that you can tell people who are patrons of bars and do come to bars, you know, maybe a little suggestion on how they should treat a bar and their owners or the acts and things like that?
Just like home.
Treat them just like home.
Just as long like as home. No problem then, you know.
Right, as long as they come from a good home, there's no problem.
That's right.
Well, Doug, it's great, and it's great to see this happening in this area, and we want to congratulate you here and say good luck with the business and just continue it here. It's a really good facility. Thanks very much, Doug Dickens at the Skyway Bowl, the back room. Take care.
Everyone likes movie talk, so here's Bruce Hallenbeck to talk about Creepshow.
Boy, you know, that guy sure can write. I don't mean me, I mean Stephen King here. He's got a new movie out called Creepshow, which I had the pleasure of seeing a couple of weeks ago. It's a horror movie, but it's not a gross horror movie like Friday the 13th. It's not the kind of a thing where you have to endure sitting through a movie for 2 hours. It's a pleasurable horror movie. It's kind of based on the old EC comics of the 50s, in which there was always a morality twist to the ending. There were always stories of poetic justice. In the movie, there are five different stories, all written by Stephen King. And in case you don't know, Stephen King is the author of Carrie and The Stand and The Shining and a lot of other best-selling novels. In the movie Creepshow, his style is a little bit more geared towards the comic books, making it more of a fun, scary movie rather than a scary, scary movie. It's not the kind of movie that's going to make you run out of the theater, but it's the kind of movie that's going to make you laugh and scream and do a lot of different things at the same time. It also happens to have a very good cast, including Hal Holbrook, Carrie Nye, Vivica Lindfors, Leslie Nielsen, and a very, very good portrayal by E.G. Marshall in the last story, in which E.G. Marshall is basically the only character in the story except for 5,000 cockroaches. That gives you an idea of what the movie's like. It's a lot of fun. It was directed by George Romero, who made Night of the Living Dead and Dawn of the Dead. It's nothing like that in the sense it doesn't have a lot of splatter effects in it, and it's not aimed at the gore freaks. But if you have a little bit of the kid in you, as Stephen King said, he and George Romero are a couple of 12-year-olds making movies, and you can see that they enjoy it just as much as the audience does. So if you are a 12-year-old inside, and if you secretly like to do things like chew your food at the dinner table and then open up your mouth and go, yeah, you're definitely going to like this movie. You don't have to be a creep to like Creepshow, although it does help to psych yourself up to really get into it. So I can really recommend Creepshow on the basis of giving you the creeps and giving you a good time. Hope you enjoy it.
I hate softball.
You hate softball?
I hate softball, and I hate softball players. Softball's for old men and little girls. Softball is a social gathering. It's like playing frisbee or something. And I don't do that.
November 22nd, 1982. Mr. George Thorogood, the Palace Theater. Just the facts, ma'am.
Your new single, Bad to the Bone, and the videotape. Really enjoyable videotape. I've been seeing it on MTV. You must have seen it at least once or twice. What do you think of the videotape?
Well, I'm a bad judge of that, Gene. You know, I'm the kind of guy that, you know, the guy comes around with a camera and takes your picture. You see yourself in it, you go, yeah, it's a great picture. You know, but as an artistic judge, I'm not all that. You know. No. I like it. I'm in it. Great.
You it's know? Like a home movie that's on national television, so.
Well, I don't know. You know, it's just, I can't really say. You got to ask the people. I mean,
okay, George, we're going to take it to the people and let them tell us just what they think of George Thorogood and his videotape, Bad to the Bone.
Now, on the day I was born, the nurses all gathered round. They gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, leave this one alone. She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone. A thousand hearts before I met you. I'll break a thousand more, baby, before I am through.
What do you think of George Thorogood? This your?
He's the baddest to the bone.
He's the baddest to the bone. Is this your first time seeing him?
Yep.
And is he all you expected him to be?
No, he's better.
He's better. Is he all you expected him to be?
Yeah, I didn't expect his show to be much. I just thought it'd be like the Grateful Dead, a lot of music, but his show's pretty good.
Yeah, that's.
I make a rich woman beg, and I make a good woman steal. I make an old woman blush, and I make a young girl squeal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby. Yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey, that I'm bad to the bone. Bad. 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 Bad to the bone.
Hello. What do you think of George Thorogood?
I think he's one of the best rock and roll musicians in the United States.
Now, there's an honest opinion. Is this your first time seeing him?
No.
When have you seen him?
At J.B. Scott's.
Huh? So is he all you expected tonight?
Yeah, oh, he's all I expected, for sure.
walk those streets, kings and queens step aside. Every woman I meet, they all stay satisfied. I want
to do you think he's a wise ass? I see he's wising off to some of the people out in the audience. You think he's a wise ass?
No.
Okay. An honest opinion of the Palace Theater. Thanks a lot. Is he ever a wise guy to the audience or the crowd?
Yeah, but, you know, everybody seems to like it.
Now, what do you think of George? Is he all you expected him to be?
Yeah, yeah, he's great.
Is he a wise guy at all?
No, kind of. He is great.
But he's kind of a wise guy.
Kind of.
Whose concept was it, the whole pool playing bit?
It's a fellow named Mark Robinson.
Was he the director?
Mm-hmm.
And it was good working with him. How about Bo Diddley? He's in the...
Well, we asked for Bo especially.
Uh-huh.
That was, if we have any credit to take for it, that's it. Which is a major credit, I suppose, because Bo helped really make it happen. And he was really a pleasure to work with. You know, funny and loose and maybe even a bigger ham than me. Happens during the night is up to the audience.
See, what do you see as being your future goals, as in your next record?
Well, I'm going to be in a movie next year with James Coburn and Verna Lisa and Sophia Loren. It's called The Women Who Loved Rock and Roll, where I played a part of James Coburn's son. It's about a four-hour movie, and it's being written by Bob Dylan.
A four-hour movie by Bob Dylan? Is this
written by him?
Written by him. Is he going to help direct it? Probably.
No. Sergio Leone is going to direct it.
Boy, and is this all set?
It's a love story.
Is this going to happen?
Well, yeah, we got some people working on it.
Well, that's great. Have you ever done any acting or anything before?
Well, you saw Bad to the Bone. That was my debut, so to speak.
Most bands that are out there in bars right now are doing cover material and that kind of thing, but you're always hearing that in order to make it national and that kind of thing, you should do originals. You did it the other way around. Do you have any advice for bands that are playing in bars right now?
Just play good songs, period.
Whether they're yours or somebody else?
Good songs. Milton Berle did not write all his material.
Hmm.
Did Paul Newman write Cat on a Hot Tin Roof?
I guess not.
He didn't.
Okay.
You know he didn't. Tennessee Williams wrote it. You see my point?
Yeah.
So you should always perform good material. It doesn't matter if you wrote it or somebody else wrote it. As long as it's good, you know, that's my point. And a lot of people say, well, if that was the case, then there would have been no original stuff happening since 1972 when Creedence Clearwater broke up. So be it. Let it die. Let it die a graceful death. Because so many bands over the years have recorded so many original songs, maybe four of them have been good over five albums. But yet they turn around, they can do other stuff so good that you kind of figure out why they keep trying. So, the Beatles kind of, in a way, spoiled everybody because they wrote all their own material. But how many acts like that come along?
Yeah.
Once in a blue moon. So my advice is just play good songs, good entertaining songs, and worry about who wrote it secondary.
Okay. Well, thanks very much, George, and have fun tonight. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us. A real product and inspiration for all these people out there. Play good songs. That's what George says.
That's what I said.
Thanks a lot, George.
Right.
The back room.
Frick, what are you eating?
I just happen to be on the magnificent collection of Irish silver art.
Oh no, I wanted to read that.
Here you go.
Let's do a taste test. Let's blindfold ourselves and see if we can tell the difference.
Almost 28. And I hate it.
Groovy idea for a song, man.
Drink beer.
Let's take a taste test. This was the beer.
You're just playing George. Oh, poor Z.
And now, here's some real fine players, Interstate, doing their tune, Wetline.
Oh, Lord, the devil's gonna get me, the devil's gonna get me by the morning light. Well, I woke in the night, the winds are ringing, and the pipes went over like a beggar in the rain. So I saw the devil, he's creeping through the darkness, fell on my knees, started to pray. Oh, Lord, the devil's gonna get me, oh, Lord, I'm creeping through the night. Oh, Lord, the devil's gonna get me, the devil's gonna get me by the morning light. The devil's gonna get me, oh Lord, keep me tonight. Oh Lord, the devil's gonna get me, the devil's gonna get me by the morning light. I'm
Interstate, real fine.
Hey, tune in again next time for your favorite local bands and personalities. And don't forget to check your TV listings and your Metroland for the schedule in the back room. We want to thank everyone who helped make this production possible. And as David Allen always says,
till the next time, till we meet again, I'll be lonesome, I'll be blue. Saying so long is never much fun when it seems like the program has only begun.
This is Uncle Funk, and it's time to say goodbye for everyone. Goodbye from myself, goodbye from Moe, who's kind of busy as you can see, and goodbye from Real George, and we'll be back at you next time.
Saying
goodbye, goodbye.
Is never my song.
Bye. 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 I'll see you. Begun. So long.
Till next time.
Bye.
Me again.